the summit. That's our target.
Here. That's amazing. You can see how far this glacier's receded, how quick it has receded. You've got all this scree slope now exposed. There's nothing growing on it yet. Things are moving fast. So Tyler, you've been coming here a while, right?
Yeah, you bet.
Yeah, and you've seen this glacier actually move, change.
Well, you can see it through the years how much it has receded.
Yeah.
Just in the scar of the landing itself.
Incredible. Huge gashes in the glacier filled with water. Water everywhere.
We're up near the top, right above the heart of the Great Bear Rainforest. We're only about 7,500 feet here, but with all that moisture that comes inland in the wintertime here, you build up a lot of snowpack, and that means a lot of glacier. So we're standing on gosh knows how many hundreds of feet of this snow, which gets packed down tight and forms the ice that travels down this mountain in sheets down towards Owakena Lake here, and then the water continues right down into Rivers Inlet. This is where the streams that the salmon make their home in gets its start, right here in these glaciers and these mountaintops. And as everybody knows by now, these glaciers, these mountaintops, are one of the things that's threatened by a changing climate. So ultimately, the health of the rainforest, the health of the salmon in those streams, comes all the way uphill and starts right here on the glacier. That roar is the roar of a glacier becoming a stream. And we're now right down here at the base of the Silverthorne Glacier. And what looks like dirt back here behind me, it's actually the dirty ice that pushes all the sediment up from that valley as it actually flows, because this ice flows down through that valley. And when it comes out here, it deposits that sediment as it recedes back up the slope. I tell you, it's incredible, this water that comes out of here. It's coming right out of ice. So when you feel it, it's not much more than freezing. But the temperature right here, it's gotta be in the 70s today. It's abnormally hot right now. And that's posing a problem. I mean, there's a tremendous volume coming down this year, and most years now we're getting a lot of melt off this glacier. And that can greatly change the dynamic of these streams. We can pretty much figure out how fast these glaciers are receding by looking at the amount of barren slope that's below them. When these glaciers recede, they're colonized pretty quickly by things like alder. Alder's a great nitrogen fixer, so it actually colonizes these slopes and recession areas very quickly. And some beautiful plants like fireweeds, just all over here. We got two different species right here. But what worries me is, as these glaciers continue to disappear, where are we gonna get the water from to support these streams? And as these glaciers continue to melt fast, we're changing the dynamics of streams. In the case of the Rivers Inlet, streams are already being impacted by logging and logging roads and sedimentation. So it's a changing world, and I'm not sure that salmon can meet the challenge of a changing world. It's amazing to see, though, the place where ice becomes water in the Great Bear. Climate conditions are dire. A rising ocean temperature has even changed the biological working of the Pacific. Glacial melt means an increase in silt, which equals a loss of salmon breeding habitat. And the increase in volume of fresh water is changing the salinity and the function of the estuary. And that's where young salmon adapt to life at sea. The protection of the forest has been a huge step forward for conservation, but we must all work together to truly preserve the Great Bear. The Great Bear Rainforest stands as one of the wonders of the natural world and as a tribute to those with a bold commitment for conservation. Ecological interconnections are everywhere we look here, but in the end, this is a gift from the sea. And the Great Bear, well, it stands as a symbol of the health of this system. From Calvert Island, British Columbia, I'm Patrick McMillan, wishing you your own exciting expedition.